When the rain fell over mid-Michigan in May of 2020, four dams in a four-lake system on the Tittabawassee River were pushed to their limits, which resulted in disaster. While the events at Edenville Dam and Sanford Dam were highly publicized, this video focuses on the Secord Dam and efforts of the Four Lakes Task Force to stabilize the dam and eventually restore Secord Lake. Secord Dam in Gladwin County is the northernmost dam in the Four Lakes system. Thankfully, Secord Dam did not breach, and in comparison to downstream dams, sustained less substantial damage. After the May 2020 flood, the Federal Energy Regulatory Commission, also known as FERC, which is the agency that regulates hydroelectric dams, ordered the dam owner, Boyce Hydro, to lower Secord Lake and complete an engineering inspection. Boyce Hydro hired engineers from TRC, a construction and engineering firm, to inspect Secord Dam along with a FERC-qualified dam safety engineer on June 9, 2020. The inspectors provided a list of critical, recommended, and non-critical action items to take on Secord Dam. During this time, Four Lakes Task Force did not have access to the dam, so engineering consultants developed planning-level cost estimates based on the available inspection reports. These estimates predict that it will cost $24 million to bring Secord Lake in compliance with dam safety standards. Finally, during the week of October 11, 2020, Four Lakes Task Force conducted its own independent investigation after negotiating an access agreement with Boyce Hydro. The task force inspection included representatives from the Michigan Department of Environment, Great Lakes, and Energy, or EGLE, the USDA Natural Resources Conservation Service, and Four Lakes Engineering Consultants, GEI, Essex Partnership, Spicer Group, and Fisher. They shared their findings with FERC and EGLE. The following is a summary of interim dam stabilization measures that will be implemented on Secord Dam from December 2020 to February 2021. The most critical item is a hole in the west concrete retaining wall, which is exposing steel rebar in the wall. If the hole is not closed, it will continue to corrode and enlarge, and the steel beams will deteriorate from rust. To repair the hole, contractors will replace the deteriorated concrete with new concrete. The upstream face of the dam also has deteriorating concrete, resulting in holes above sheet pile cutoff. This calls for similar repair measures of replacing the concrete to seal the holes. There are several other concrete repairs planned as well. Erosion and high flow volumes sheared pieces of concrete off the left retaining wall, which will be stabilized for winter operations. The fourth interim measure is to add new gate connection detail to the tainter gates. Contractors will also fill soil and rock behind the concrete training wall to stabilize the dam and fix erosion damage on the tail race area. Other interim repairs include restoring and improving electrical service and security cameras, closing and sealing the turbine shaft gates so water doesn't flow through the hollowed underside of the dam, and installing safety railings, safety harness tie-off points, and de-icing equipment so operators can safely de-ice the dam in the winter. With the hydroelectric generator shut down, water must pass over the concrete spillway. In the winter, the water turns to ice, which must be periodically removed from the dam. While the list of necessary repairs for Secord Dam is quite lengthy, the interim measures will simply lessen safety risks during winter operations, spring runoff, and future high-flow events. These interim measures are about half of our budget of $1 million for repairs on the Secord Dam through 2021. More comprehensive repairs are needed to restore Secord Lake to its normal legal lake level. These efforts are not expected to begin until January 2022. These interim repairs are financed primarily by appropriations from the state of Michigan. To implement winter repairs, Four Lakes Task Force is working with FERC and EGLE to secure permits. Fisher Contracting, a Midland-based civil contracting firm, will perform interim measures from December 2020 to February 2021. During construction, the dam spillway gates will be lowered to provide better and safer working conditions for work taking place downstream of the spillway. Gate openings will be maintained per the EGLE permit to maintain the appropriate base flow downstream. Property owners may see Secord Lake rise up to 18 inches during this time. Once repairs conclude, the spillways will open again and the water will recede. The task force continues to collaborate with state and federal agencies and engineering consultants to develop feasibility and flood studies, which will be published in the spring of 2021. In the meantime, the task force operations transition team is in place, ready to safely transfer the Secord, Smallwood, Edenville, and Sanford Dam assets from Boise Hydro to Four Lakes Task Force. To learn more about Secord Dam repairs, visit the Four Lakes Task Force website.